everybody.
Hey. All right, so we got all the ingredients here to catch some fish, I think. So got Brad Jonborn here from Brad's. He's gonna, what he's been doing is tying up some rigs, some slip tie, some two hook plus a special secret one we're gonna show you in a minute. You gotta hold on if you wanna see that though. But two hook slip rigs for trolling for salmon. Now in the shop here, we have fixed tied and slip tied leaders, you know, already here, but what Brad's tying up are bigger hooks, 3-aught and 4-aught hooks, which you might want. Now, Brad, I've noticed this right off, the ones we have in the package, those are different hooks.
Yeah.
So I kind of like these better.
Yeah, better.
Yeah, these are some mean looking hooks right here. Yeah, I mean, this is different than the typical Brad's hook from the past, right? Yeah, got some upgraded hooks here. I kind of like these. So they got the bend to them and the wide gap, and these look like really good hooks. So what Brad's gonna do is show you how he ties the slip tie, and then another super secret kind of slip tie using these little tiny octopus hooks. You may or may have not have ever seen anything like this, so you're gonna like this. And then he's gonna show you how he rigs up the herring with it. So, all right, so first of all, he's got 30 pound CXX going here, which is super strong stuff.
Yeah, it's super slippery. It's hard to tie hooks with it. It's so slippery. It's the strongest line made in the market. Boy, it's hard to get started. It's pretty hard to get started, guys. It's going to let go of it. Jeez. Sorry.
Pressure.
Hey, it's slippery. I can't get hard to start. Wow. There you go.
There we go.
I wrap it 5 times. Pull it right here, so it doesn't unravel on you. Go to the other end. You go through the other direction now, about an inch or so. That line is your thumb, put it in your thumb. Same one you used last time, wrap it 7 times. So it's 5 and 7.
Okay, so that's basically an egg loop.
It is.
All right. So that's going to be the top hook, right?
Right.
No, that's going to be the bottom hook.
Right, bottom hook. Yeah.
Yeah, that's this hook, the bottom.
Then
hook.
I take a cloth line called Dacron.
Okay, so it's 30 pound Brad's Dacron.
Go through the other hook, grab it just twice. So that's a cushion for the slide on, so it won't show your line. You wrap it twice more again. That holds it in place. Which finger doesn't unravel, and it'll go right to the end, and lay it right alongside.
So you're not putting it through the loop again, you're just...
Stay right on the side.
Oh, okay.
And wrap it. Boy, I'm having pressure now, huh? The more reps you give this, the harder it is to slide the hook.
Right.
So I usually give about 7 or 12 wraps.
Okay. Now with the Dacron, using a Dacron so it doesn't chew up your line as you're sliding
right
up and down.
You just pull it semi-tight and then slide down wherever you want it.
Yeah.
After you slide down where you want it, then you know you tighten up pretty good.
Okay. All right. So the reason you'd want to use a slip tie as opposed to a fixed tie, and some people, it's one of those things that some people really like fixed ties, and some people would always use slip ties.
It's just sliding where you want to slide.
Yeah. So main reason for using a slip tie, Brad, is because for the netting when you...
Well, no, you use slip ties, you use a different size herring.
Oh, well, okay, yeah, right.
Different bend.
Yeah, okay, so you can adjust the gap between your hooks to fit
right
whatever size herring, but also when you're netting a fish, if you get it tangled up in the net, then the slip is going to theoretically help you not lose as many fish in the net, or break off, you know, you're not breaking off your second hook all the time in the net. So, yeah, there's two good reasons to use slip tie, but a lot of guys prefer the fixed tie. And so that's why we have them both in the shop here. All right, now he's got a little tiny third hook in his hand.
I love this hook. This works so well. You won't believe it. It's only for a whole herring though. You want to use it with a couple. You want to use just a whole herring.
Yeah. Okay. So this is a special rig. He's tying in a number 4 octopus, Brad's hook here, on top of the two hooks that he's already got tied up. So it's gonna look like that, and he's using the Dacron. And he's gonna show you how to rig that up. So this is like super secret one here.
All the guys know about it. It's just kind of a hush-hush one.
Yeah, not really a secret, but, you know, we like to say stuff like that. Okay, so there's your three-hook rig tied with Dacron. All right, now this little teeny tiny hook here, you're not expecting to catch a salmon on that.
I have.
You have?
Yeah.
Okay. But
no, I shouldn't do it. I've caught two fish.
Yeah. Well, that's good. You know you don't have your drag too tight if you can catch a fish on that hook right there. Okay, so let's see what we're doing here.
Well, it just goes through the bottom of the tail, halfway through and out.
Okay.
Well, the next one goes just below the gill plate. Out. You slide it up.
Alright.
And then the third hook goes in the mouth. Keep it shut.
There you go.
The main thing is you want to get the right bend though. So you want to get the right
bend. Okay.
Bend. I like about that kind of a bend like that.
Yeah.
So you just slide everything up. See that bend.
Okay. Yeah, so that slip tie enables you to get that bend in it.
There you go.
Beautiful.
That works so good, you won't believe it, guys. It gets a perfect spin, yeah. I think.
Okay, so what's so important about having the mouth shut like that?
With the mouth open, it'll open up and it'll wreck your hearing.
Yeah, yeah, so the mouth opens up, fills with water and the water pressure, and it tears your hearing apart. But that pins it shut. I've seen other ways the guys have tried to
this
pin it.
This is in line, though. It fits perfect. It's hard to believe the spin you this thing. It's unreal.
Yeah, I've seen like toothpicks being used and all kinds of ways to try to keep the mouth shut and to get the herring bent, but that's super simple.
And it works great.
Yeah, all right.
And we'll have these tied here at the shop, too, right by.
With the three hooks?
Yes.
Cool, right on. All right, so we got these available in the store as soon as he ties up a few more. I know he did the regular two hook already,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I did 25 through it.
He did 25 of those. Now he's going to do, I guess, 25 like this. So if you want these, you better get in here. Then we'll probably, I guess we'll put them on the website too. These hooks will be available on the website real soon. I think Kyra's working on that right now. And so we might as well put those on there too. But they're going to be in a different package. Here's one, you know.
Just hand tie yours.
We don't have the fancy packaging here, but 4-0, 5-0 slip, and you did 3-0 and 4-0.
I'm going to.
You're going to. Okay.
4-0, 5-0.
Yeah.
Number 4. 4-0, number 4.
And like say, these are Brad's hooks, the 2X ultra sharp hook, size 4-0. Right. These are some mean looking hooks. These aren't the same Brad's hooks that you might be used to. These are
different. Those are just samples of me in the shop. We'll be in until probably another month now. We'll get them in.
Oh, so these aren't available?
Not
like,
available yet.
Oh, so these are like exclusive here.
Yeah,
cool. Yeah, these are good looking hooks. Nice wide gap, and they just look like.
They're mean, are they?
They look mean.
Yeah.
Right on. Cool. Get some good Brad's hooks.
Thanks, guys.
Like that. All right. So, got in here. You can get yourself some leaders. Oh, and I'm going to let you in on a little secret, too. On Monday, we're going to have a special on herring and brine and bite. This is an unbrined, you know, herring here. It's just the way it looks. But it's going to fish a lot better if you put it in some brine and bite and maybe some brine and bite complete if you want to, you know, color it up. And we're going to have a special on that Monday. To where it's a really good deal. So I'm just going to tell you guys here on YouTube, you're the only ones that know. You'll be buy a bottle of Brine and Bite, or Brine and Bite Complete, any along those lines, and you're going to get a free pack of herring. So that's a really good deal on Monday. Yeah, really good deal. So I'll show you what I mean here. So tray bait, you know, just be based on what we have left, but we got quite a few. So Green Label tray bait or herring. You know, any of the tray baits, and then over here, talking all the brine and bite complete. So, that was on the big bottles. I was thinking the big bottles, but we can make a deal on the small bottles. Maybe you want two small bottles, we can work with you on that. And then the Brine and Bite Complete Powder. But we got the Brilliant Blue and the Green Chartreuse. Blue Natural, the Chartreuse. If you haven't ever used Chartreuse for Springers, you might want to give that a try. The Green kills. But you get some of those Brad's two hook rigs, brine up some bait, and get out there and do some fishing. And I'm pretty sure you're gonna catch some fish. Right on. All right, you guys. So we'll hope to see you in here soon. We got tons of Washington shrimp. We got tons of good Procure bait that's going fast. We still have quite a bit. We sold about half of it so far, but we still probably have like 25 jars there and much bait and stuff. So it's looking good. So hope you guys are having a great weekend. And we'll be talking to you soon. Be sure to subscribe.